Shuffleton's Barbershop. This is a Hallmark film, also known as A Way Back Home. And I feel like this got off to a really slow start for me. There were some really weird editing decisions made in the first, maybe third of the film. But once the film got going and it really gained momentum, and the narrative was explained well enough that I actually knew what was going on, it was pretty remarkable, and I'm not ashamed to admit that I did actually get, emotional quite towards the end. I'm not going to divulge the ending, don't worry, no spoilers here, but I do recommend this film completely. As I said, the beginning was a little bit slow on the uptake, and some of the flashbacks just weren't edited in very well. But aside from that, pretty great. This was released in 2013, directed by Mark Jean and written by John Wilder, starring Austin Starwell as our protagonist, Trey Cole. And we also have Jason Cameron, played by Bryant Prince. Jason is the child character in this. Every Hallmark film has to have a child character to evoke emotions. It's just the way they do things. And he is brilliant. He looks up to Trey as, I guess, a father figure. Trey is actually his uncle, and he's actually met Trey for the first time because Trey comes back home after being away for quite a long time. It's not really that clear why he comes home. I mean, he comes home to tell his uncle something, but I don't know why he couldn't have just phoned ahead first. I'm not sure when this is set, by the way. It's not con well, it kind of feels not contemporary, but at the same time, I've just realised that Jason was playing with a Nintendo DS at one point. So, really, yeah, he definitely could have phoned ahead. I'm not sure what that was all about. That's another thing that, now that I'm thinking about it, doesn't really seem very well thought through. The timing of this is just not very well displayed at all. So there's a plot hole for you. Beyond that, once he comes back, he is a famous musician. He gets a little bit of attention, but he doesn't want that. He just wants to, well, now that he's back, he wants to get to know his nephew, and it's all about Trey spending time with Jason, but not without its problems. Jason himself is worried that Trey is going to leave again. Trey has issues with his own father and aspects of his past that are going to come back to haunt him. And I kind of feel like, on the one hand, I've not explained that very well. Everything I've said is a little bit all over the place. But that's the narrative. That's what happens. It's all over the place. And it did take quite a while for things to make any sense and for threads to kind of tie together enough that I could understand what the character's motivations were or what he was trying to achieve. And maybe you could argue that because the character himself was confused, it was reflected in the narrative. But I think that's giving the film a bit too much credit. Ultimately, though, once it got going, I did enjoy it. If it wasn't for Jason as a character, I wouldn't have liked it as much. I think his character definitely drove things forward at a pretty reasonable pace. I liked seeing Trey interact with him and them, them building their relationship up. That's something that I really enjoyed. There's a nice message in this about the relationship between father and son, and ultimately, the messages that are delivered work well once they actually take the time to do it. Danny Glover plays Charlie, who is Trey's uncle. Not his real uncle, but he referred to him as uncle. And they had a really strong emotional connection growing up. And that, again, is really beautiful to watch. It's all about father figures, whether biological fathers, uncles, de facto uncles. It's really beautiful to watch in that regard, but it's not perfect. So my advice would be, yes, watch it, but stick with it. It's difficult to begin with and not very good, but after the first third has passed and it's finally found its feet, Shuffleton's Barbershop is an absolute delight. Really emotional, you will well up. Ultimately, it delivers itself very well once it knows what it's doing.